is the first day of the event. It's a unique opportunity for the defense industry of Turkey to showcase latest innovation and technology of the defense industry. For example, FNSS showcased for the first time its new amphibious combat vehicles, and Otokar exhibit its Agrip 2 in electric version. We have the chance also to see latest innovation of drones with the armored drones and new helicopter.
So the Agrip 2 here doing the first public debate this year in IDEF. It's a three-man crew, gunner, driver and the commander reconnaissance platform, but the power pack here we display is all electric. So the configuration of the vehicle is all power pack is at the back, and the electric batteries and the inverter and the drive system, power electronics, are at the rear of the vehicle. The crew sits in the empty center portion of the vehicle, and there is a bonnet in front of it. So the vehicle is capable of carrying up to 9mm turrets, which is a good payload for this size of a vehicle. This is a full electric vehicle. The existing configuration that we have here is capable of supporting the vehicle for most of the vehicle's functioning, about 200 kilometers range with the existing batteries. However, the battery sizes, the battery pack, can be doubled using the front stowage, and this can be increased according to the mission profile. The battery pack is a quick change one, so in the field a fully charged battery can be changed at a very quick time, so that its fully charged batteries can continue with the full mission.
Welcome to Turkey and IDEF exhibition. Asisgard is a newly established company, mainly focused in four areas like electro-optics, vehicle electronics for military, UAV systems, basically the rotorcraft drones, and some other hybrid areas including artificial intelligence and machine learning. There is only one thing interesting about this drone actually, because drones are everywhere and drones carry almost everything, including human beings. However, when the drones carry machine guns like this, and when the machine guns start firing, this stabilization becomes a problem for the drone to safely navigate, plus the drone to effectively gunfire. So this is the engineering problem we have solved on this platform. This drone works or operates in a radius of 10 kilometers and flies up to the altitudes of 2,800 meters and effectively gunfire from ranges up to 800 meters, but for an endurance of 30 minutes, carries 200 bullets of NATO standard 5.56 caliber. It is fully designed and developed in Turkey by four Turkish industries coming together under the management of Asisgard, where we selected each company for their expertise in the specific area.
My name is Fatih Köse. I am Land Vehicles Design Manager in Tümosan. And this is our final product, Pusat, Tactical Wheeled Armored Vehicle. Now we are presenting our second and updated version of the Pusat vehicle in this exhibition. This vehicle is using our indigenous engine transmission and powertrain and also suspension solutions, which is designed by Tümosan. And also this vehicle is based on a chassis structure which has modular design. It has a different crew capsule, and it has different armor structure, which makes us enable to adapt the user requirements to the vehicle very easily. if you look at the details, it has really significant differences. For example, because of the our four-cylinder engine, which has really compact dimensions, our nose structure is really small comparing to the other vehicles. So it makes us to increase the approach angle, and it gives us advantage in the off-road conditions. Our vehicle has a really high approach angle, and because of this chassis structure, it has its crew capsule is totally isolated from the running gear of the vehicle. It creates also advantage regarding to the MVH issues, which is really critical in this kind of vehicles. We are working with Aselsan. We have adapted the Saab remote control weapon station on this vehicle, and also very first time we have adapted the Saab Zafer system, which is capable of loading the ammunition from the inside of the vehicle. That's why we have there is a sliding hatch on the roof of the vehicle, you can see. Our vehicle is highly anticipated by the users. They really want this vehicle to use on the field for their own tests. So as Tumosan, our target is also to make this vehicle ready for their test on the field.
My name is Mazlum Savaş Onur. I am STM Naval Project Director. I retired 2002 and I have been requested by Undersecretary Defense Industry to be involved with our National Ship Program. We basically engineering company. We don't have manufacturing plant, but we can do any kind of ship construction in any shipyard around the world. This is our Milgem Corvette, which is designed nationally, headed by Turkish Navy design team. We support our Navy to design this ship. Also, we provide material and equipment to build this ship, 70% using local industry. It means that 70% of this ship material, equipment, manufactured in our local industry. This is a big experience. The other one is a fast attack craft developed by ourselves. This is a very high speed, low signature boat. You see, this is a very stealth design, very low radar cross section, very low magnetic signature, and shallow draft.
I am Ömer Korkut. I am Deputy General Manager of STM. I'm responsible for technology, including autonomous systems, cybersecurity, RF and simulation technologies, and command control systems. Here we are in front of our autonomous drone family. We have combat ready three products right now. Kamikaze, this one is operational in the field, both in Turkish Armed Forces and also Gendarmerie and Police Force. And right now, it can be operable in just 45 seconds, and it stays in the air for 25 minutes. So there is a laser rangefinder, the user using the ground control station can detect and can decide for the attack.
Here in IDEF, we also display our Tulpar medium tank. This is a 35 to 40 ton class medium tank. This type of platform is a medium tank. And some of the countries use this configuration as an infantry fire support vehicle. So Tulpar platform is capable of doing whatever that mission requires. So here in this configuration, we have Tulpar on top. CMI's 105 millimeter turret with autoloader. So it has a two-man turret and can be capable of firing all types of 105 millimeter NATO ammunition. Driver, the road speed is 78 kilometers per hour with a range of 700 kilometers. It runs on diesel fuel and the water wading depth is 1.2 meters. The trench crossing capability since we have 7 road wheels, the trench crossing capability is 2.5 meters, which provides also a good soft soil capability due to long track width.